Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about open and closed root finding methods for solving nonlinear equations. So, when solving a nonlinear system, using numerical methods, we are trying to locate the roots of the function. That is where the function crosses the x-axis. To do this, we have tons of algorithms, which we will talk about more in future videos. However, all of these algorithms fit into two general methods. That is, we can classify all of our solution algorithms for nonlinear systems as either open or closed methods. A closed root finding method finds a root between two specific boundaries. So, we give our algorithm a lower boundary, so a value to the left of our suspected root, and an upper boundary, an input value that is higher than our suspected root. Within these boundaries, we iterate our algorithm as we progressively move closer to our root of interest. Some examples of this type of numerical method are the bisection method and the false position method, which will be explained more thoroughly in coming videos. The way in which we prove that there is a root present between our two intervals is by evaluating our function at both of our input boundaries. Then, we multiply those outputs together. If we receive two negative outputs or two positive outputs, we would get a positive product. Whereas, if we multiply a negative and a positive output, we will get a negative product. And because we get a negative product, we know that we have a root within that boundary, as we must cross the x-axis. One problem with closed root finding methods is that if a root contains 0, or 2, or even more roots, obviously we are going to have a problem. With 0 roots, we cannot find a root since, well, obviously there isn't a root present. With multiple roots, we cannot perform our root present test since we can have a function that looks like this. And even though we still receive a negative product, our two roots present will cause problems with the algorithms that we will cover in coming videos. These closed methods are also generally a bit slower than open root finding methods. However, they are excellent at finding a root as long as the function is well behaved. So, in summary, closed root finding methods are found through defining boundaries and then continually closing in on our root that we are trying to find. Since these are iterative numerical methods, they give us an approximation of the root to our desired acceptable level of error, and not the exact value. An open root finding method finds a root through an initial guess as to where we think the root may be. So, instead of defining an upper and lower boundary, isolating our root like we did in the closed root finding methods, in open root finding methods, we just make an initial guess, and depending on factors, such as the slope of the function, we can determine in which direction we need to move from our initial guess to where we think the root is located. Some examples of open root finding methods are Newton's method and the secant method. A large benefit to open methods over a closed method is that open methods are much faster at finding roots. However, as a counter to this, open methods are much more likely to diverge, which means that they will not be able to find the root. We will just move further and further away from it. To mitigate the potential of divergence, we need to select a starting guess that is close to our root and try to ensure that our function is well behaving. In the coming videos, we will be going through many different root finding algorithms. There will be videos on both the theory, examples done by hand, examples done in Excel, and likely in a few programming languages as well. If there are any programming languages or implementation of these methods that you would like to see, just leave a comment down below and I will try to complete that. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of the differences between open and closed root finding methods. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.